through a lot of trial and error, I have figured this thing out, and I think I've got it all figured out so that it's going to work. I've got the direction on this guy right. I know what level the tank has to be at so that water will run downhill and into the tank and not have to run uphill to get there. So I think I got all the little problems worked out, and I figured out the framework that I'm using to hold it up. And this is just like a big erector set. And you know, when I was a kid, I didn't really like erector sets. I didn't like them, but this is just like an erector set. And I'm using small carriage bolts because they're flat on top. There we go. Three times I pulled out one of the other six bolts, and there was like 20 of these in there. At any rate, I guess I should go get a lottery ticket. Oh, they don't sell them in Nevada. Using small carriage bolts. See? They're flat on top somewhat, rounded flat, so they're not going to make the tank stick up too far off the frame, and because they're not sharp, doesn't have any sharp edges, it won't wear into the tank. So that's what's holding this all together right now. These straps are going to be, there's going to be, and again, I'm not really here to show you how to mount your tank to your trailer. This trailer was not designed to have a gray tank, so that's why I'm having so many problems with it. If it was just a replacement, it would be easy, and you wouldn't even need to see this part of the video. So these are going to be connected here. They'll be folded under and bolted to the bottom and come up about this far, and I'll have probably two on each side, each end. Let's call these the ends. Two or three, probably two. And it will go up here and connect to the framework, the C channel of the trailer. And then also, I'm going to have two of them spaced out under here like this. They'll have to be longer. I've got longer ones over here. They will span the bottom of the trailer and be bolted in at the L channel, at the, you know, on each side here, they'll be actually bolted in at the bottom. So it will hold these two angle brackets, and keep them from separating, okay? And then they will also be bent up and will attach to frame, more framework under the trailer. So it'll be suspended, that way it'll be suspended by at least 2, 4, 6, or 8 straps. And the framework here will also be held together because of the fact that it'll be bolted underneath, so it can't separate and the weight of the tank go busting through. So I'm covering it from all directions. I did kind of figure it all out. I didn't see any reason to put much of it on paper. The one thing I did put on paper was when I figured out the tank and where the holes had to be, I figured all that out on paper before I made my order. Okay, enough talk, let's get this done. All right, this is the bottom. I've got it upside down, this is the bottom. I want you to see what I've done. I put a strap around here, which I'll show you in a minute. Bolted it here and there, and I've got bolts hanging down. Oop, this one came out. I gotta get back in there, dang it. But anyway, I got bolts hanging out here, there, there, three here. It's supposed to be three on this side, but this one I gotta put back in. It got flipped around when I was messing with it. But anyway, these will be suspension places, which will hold the entire mechanism up to the bottom of the trailer. But I needed a strap around here to keep the whole thing from being able to bounce out. And also, when I'm lifting it up and down, I want it to be able to, you know, I'm going to be lifting on this portion of it, but I want the frame to stay with it. So for a couple of reasons, I needed a strap all the way around it. And it's real quick, like, the way I was able to get this folded over, because you'll find if you do this, you're going to go, oh, how did he get that hole over that bolt? You know, and the only way I was able to do it was to squeeze everything together here with this bar clamp. And then it folded right over. So that's a problem you may run into, and now you know the solution. I had to figure that out for myself. You have to use your imagination with this stuff. When you're inventing stuff, as you move through the process of building, you're going to run into all kinds of little problems that you didn't expect. And when you, in your mind, it looks right, and yeah, you can draw it on paper, but then when you go to put it in practical use, you run into problems, and you have to solve these problems as you move along. So you have to use your imagination and go, okay, well, what would help me accomplish what I'm trying to do? And now you've seen what I did. Okay, so now we're going to flip it over. All these bolts will now stay in place because they can't go anywhere. Those are all carriage bolts. They've got that little square thing on the bottom. And the good thing about that is that they won't spin. They won't spin in these, as long as you put them in the slots here. If you put them in the round holes, they will, but if you put them in the slots, they won't spin. Actually, I don't even think they fit in the round holes. These are 5/16 carriage bolts. And I think they're 3/4 of an inch long. So, now, I'm going to flip this over and you'll see the strap that I was talking about. And there it is. It does its job. Now that thing can't come bouncing out of here when I go to put it on the lift and lift the whole thing up. Not to mention when the trailer is bouncing down the road, it's not going to come jumping out and get discombobulated in the frame. So just sort of a safety item there. Now our next job is to get this thing. I've got all these things. I used the white plumber's tape. It's not here, it's over there, but you know what I'm talking about. Wrapped it around all these threads, even though it's plastic into plastic, I still went ahead and wrapped it with plumber's tape. So everything, I don't want anything to leak. And these have washers inside, this guy. So there's no need for plumber's tape on these fittings. And then of course from here on out, it's all gonna be glue. Again, this is the vent that goes straight up all the way through the trailer. Over here I have, you're not even seeing this, are you? Let me zoom out. There you go. All right, so this is the vent going straight up all the way through the trailer to allow air to escape the tank at a fast rate and fumes, anything else. This is the one that the kitchen sink drains into. Then of course this is the shower. So next thing to do is to get it under the trailer, which is always, and things getting heavier and heavier too. So without help, this is a lot of fun. As you keep adding more weight to it with the fittings and the bolts and the nuts and the super strut, this L metal here, super strut, it gets heavier and heavier. Up to about where it's supposed to be. About there. Yeah, right about there, I think. I'm going to have to brace it up with something. And the next problem will be getting the bolts through the C-channel. Because it won't be too much of a problem, I don't think, because I can reach up in there. So this guy might be in my way a little bit. I'll just move him out of the way. Yeah, it's not even as bad as I thought it would be. It'd be about a half inch below the framework. I wanted it up tight, but there's just no room for that. So I'll go ahead and get something to shove under there. Looks like 11 5/8. They're about 11 3/4. Yeah, 11 3/4. Almost a foot.
This should hold it up. I want it to be. That's where I want it. Maybe even just a tad lower. From the fold on each one, we want it to be no longer than 8.5. Okay, we don't want it going up past this frame. So I'm going to make 3 of them. Hardest part of the job is getting these nuts started, because it's cheap Chinese junk. Cheap Chinese junk. Alright, there it is. Got the 3 hangers on each end. Got the strap fastened in the middle. Okay, well, I guess I wasn't keeping track of what I was doing, but 2 of these go underneath. They will hook up eventually, for, you know, and I can put these on after the thing is hung and under there. And which is what I'm going to do, because I don't know how far it has to go this way or that way. I still have to manufacture that. I ended up using one of them, so oh well. Go figure. I guess I wasn't watching what I was doing. I'll have to go down and get another one of those, but that's okay. So here we go again. I didn't keep track. Oh, it's getting heavy. I didn't keep track of how many times I've done this. I think this might be, just might be the last time. Better not say that, don't jinx myself. Now, all I gotta do is start drilling some holes and bolting it. So, that should be it. Now, I want it hanging down just a bit so none of this plumbing is this piece here, so it's not touching the top because it'll warp and wear through. And then I'll adjust this by bringing the 90 down a little bit. That guy right there, that should take care of that. And if it doesn't, I'll just take a little notch out of that stringer there. So, in-rigger, I guess you'd call it. All right, so I just got to get this level and where I want it, about there, I think, and drill some holes and put some bolts in it. Now I put the pipes in, the uprights that go, see, that go up through the floor. I put those in on both ends so that, you know, to make sure that it's in the right place. Because I don't want to have to do any more mods. So I got my drill ready, a cobalt bit, and I'll put my little stand under here. I'll put my little stand under here for the height. Go. So the pipe is through. It's not moving much. The marks that I made are right on. See right there? The mark that I made. Ready to drill a hole. I'll use the center punch and to get things started. And I'll start with the center one.
Okay, one suggestion I'll give you. Especially if you're in an awkward position trying to drill through metal, it can be very tough. Use cobalt drills. Cobalt drill bits will stay sharp longer. They are sharper to begin with, and they'll go through the steel much, much easier and much quicker. So they're expensive. They're 20 bucks each. I've got three or four of them, but if you use cobalt drill bits, I used them on my heater up there, and boy, that made a big difference because otherwise I was spending 10 minutes drilling one hole. So, and it's still not going to be real easy because I'm laying down, pushing sideways, all that good stuff. But the cobalt drill bits really help.
Get that right in the center. There. Now the bit won't run around on me. All right, you don't need to see this long, boring drill job. Just gonna drill a hole. All right, here you can see, I just drilled the holes. I started with this one and drilled the hole and bolted it in. And I was able to just reach up in there with my arm to get the bolt to protrude out this way. And then I went over to this one and got this one right. Got everything level. I have this end tilted down just a hair. Okay, and that is to make up for the height of the drain, which is just a little bit above the bottom of the tank. So I want to make use of every square or cubic inch of the tank. Capacity. So I've got it tilted down just a little bit in front there, as you can see. I also have it tilted towards me, so the other side is up a little higher. So that gravity brings everything over to this drain pipe here, which is an inch and a half pipe. So you can see how this all worked out. Getting it up there was a lot of fun, but I got it done. And now I'm going to add a couple of restraining straps, one or two of them, probably two, forwards this way and backwards this way for start and stop motion to keep from wearing on these mounts when this tank is full. Here we are on the other side, and as you can see, it's pretty much the same. Get those retaining straps on there. I'm still inventing that. I have in my head how I want to do it, but I need a strap going back and connecting to that cross member up there so that when you come to a stop abruptly, the forward momentum does not allow this tank to move forward in any way. It feels solid. It doesn't feel like it's going to, but I want to help it. And then the same for taking off. Need one in the front going up to that
frame member there. All right, there she is, all ready to be plumbed. And I've actually already cut all that, so haven't done under the sink yet, but I've done what's under here that needs to go to the shower. So we're gonna do that next. But as you can see, all I did was marked where the holes were with a red felt tip pin, used a center punch, and I started out with a 1/4 inch cobalt drill bit to drill halfway through, and then I went with the 5/16 for the bolts that are going through there. Those are all 5/16 bolts. And I was just able to reach my arm, like I said, you know, up in between there to get the bolts through. But then I added these straps. They go all the way, as you can see there, from the frame member on the left, down underneath, they bolt to both sides of the frame. See? And go all the way to the back. And then up there. There you go. Up there. See, all the way across. You can see there. That's why you remember when I was building the frame, I left those bolts going through there, those little carriage bolts. All right, and those are also 5/16. So it's all 5/16 except for the corner pieces, which are right there, which are 1/4 inch. All right, and I think I might have shown some of the process of making that, but it was the same is making these. I had to get under here 100 million times, make marks, go outside, do some bends while it was snowing, then come back in here until I got it right. As I said, I'm not here to show you how to build your framework, because yours may vary. But you get the gist of it. The main part of this, the main thing I'm showing you here is how to design your tank and order it for your needs. That's the most important part here. The rest of it, you can either hire it out or do it yourself, or if you know how to weld, that might be a help. I did it all out of the Erector Set type stuff, which is called Super Strut. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and make that connection up there, and that's the trap, the new kind of HEPBO trap that we're using, and it's gonna go over here to right up there, the drain for the shower. All right, this is the connector piece that's going to go from the HEPBO trap on the tank to the shower. It'll sit like that, and actually it'll be more like that in there. So I'm gonna glue this piece all up. Oops. Then we'll just install the whole thing. If I can get this guy out of here. Now remember, everything fits easier if you clean up your edges. Not sure that I did that on this one. Gonna do it now just to make sure. You can either put the glue in the accepting piece or into the piece you're putting in. It's up to you. This is a cleaner way to do it. Put it in there and twist, just like that, and let it dry. See, we just put that in there. This ABS stuff comes with its own applicator. Twist, let it dry. Same thing here. There we go. Yeah, this edge I already cleaned up. See, just like that. You got a few seconds to work with it. There. So this is all ready to install now. Of course, you know how it goes when I film. Everything always goes wrong. So I can make mistakes in front of you, so you don't have to. So, gonna, whoops, I get glue all over the place. That's why I got a piece of paper down here. Okay, I'm gonna glue this up real good. And we're gonna stick it on there. bit of twisting action on the knee, and there we go. All right, now we can let that dry because it's perfect. And I'll give this a few minutes to dry, and then we'll go ahead and pull this guy out, put some glue in it, and pop him back up there. This worked out just fine. Can you see that? I know you're looking in the light. But there it is. And here's the one I just glued. So next we'll, after that dries for a few minutes, then we'll pop this down and put some glue on it and pop it back up. Alrighty, let's pull this down now and get some glue. Alright, goes in here like this. We just pop this up in like that, and there it is. So that's a done deal. The shower is connected to the tank now. It's all glued, screwed, and ready to go. So that's how you do that. Now, while I'm waiting for that to dry, I decided to go ahead and start figuring out how I was going to mount this thing. Of course, we want the guillotine valve to pull straight out, and we also want the hose connector to point straight out. We're not even going to be using that part because we don't have a waste tank. That's for the waste side. I'm going to use some of this flat straight super strut for the hang to hang it with. All right, and I need a piece of framework, and that's why I left this hole up here inside open all this time where the toilet goes, because of the fact that I knew I was going to have to put some framing in there to hold this mechanism at some point in time. So I measured it across. It's 19 1/4. I'm going to pop that up in there, and then the super strut stuff will hang from there, see? And this thing will hang about there, and I'll run it to these bolts that hold everything together. Okay, you'll see. It'll be like that, only straight. That'll be up in there. This will be back here some. Don't want anything protruding out past the side, so you want it just up to that, like about there. All right, so I'm gonna put this piece up in here, figure out these, cut them. Oh, looky here, we get to use the pocket hole jig. Haven't used it in a while. Get a straight shot. There we go. One more. See, like that. It's going to hold the guillotine valve, the waste valve, in. And then I'll probably also run a strut or two back to here to keep it, you know, back to here or something to keep it stationary so it doesn't move this way, so it won't be flimsy that way. You'll see. You have to invent this as you go. All right, as you can see, I've mounted a couple of brackets there, and I think, like I said, I'm probably going to go ahead and mount two more that would either go across like this, I don't know, or bend it and have them come up like this to go back as a strut to, yeah, that's probably what I'm going to do, as a strut to keep it from wobbling this way. Actually, it would go like this, I think. I think I put these on the wrong end. I don't know. Now I have to go look at it and see, but you get the idea. Okay, looks like I got it right. So anyway, this thing's going to sit here like this. I'll have to cut the tops of those things because I got them a little long, which is okay. I'll mark them and cut them. But this is going to go like this, and then what I'll do is I'll take some struts. I can't hold it and show you at the same time. It'll be like this, and I'll have some struts go from these bottom bolts here back to the mechanism and bolt it there, I think, maybe, or something. We'll see. I'm going to get it hung first, and then I can figure it out, because it's hard to hold it with your, you know, like this and do your figuring.
We want this just a tad bit downhill. Okay. Let's see, I think... Yeah, that's perfect there. Okay, just like that. Got it.
I've got it mounted temporarily with clamps. And I have run a level from the exit point of the tank, you see over there, to here, to make sure it's going a little bit downhill, and it is. So that's good. And what I think I'm gonna do is I'll make a strap, and I will run it from here to that point there to keep it from doing this. And I've spread these out into a V shape for to take care of sway the other way. So I think that's gonna be a good way to hang this thing. Okay, there she is. So all you do is you take this cap off and hook up your hose to there, and then you pull this lever and boom, it dumps. Push this lever back in and it's closed again. This lever over here we aren't using, so we just leave it closed because this is for the 3-inch. We're not using that. That's for black water. And as you can see, my idea worked. I just mounted it there all the way up and I put a strut back. Let me go to the other side where I'm not shining into the light. There you go. You can see that strut I put back to the tank right here. And boy, that thing is solid. It is solid. It's not going anywhere at all now. Shakes the whole trailer when you try and shake that. So the waste water comes out through here, in there, pull the guillotine valve and it dumps, push it back in, you're closed, and it's under the trailer, it doesn't stick out. So we're good, and nothing is lower than the tank itself, and the tank is higher than the bottom of the axle, so everything will be should be fine, as long as she doesn't go four-wheeling too deep with this thing. Now I'm just waiting for this cap to come in that's just like this, but it's got a little hose connector on it so she can run a hose out and let it drain somewhere into the ground because it's just gray water. Well, now I just have to run the stack up through the bathroom out the top of the roof for the tank vent and plumb in under the sink, and we're done with this part. All right, let's see if there's enough water in there yet. I just tested the drains on the shower. No leaks. Oh, there we go, a little water coming out. But yeah, she's working. There's no leaks, that's the main thing. That is the main thing. Good. No leaks. That's great. Well, that was a really interesting yet fun installation. And I want to thank Steve from Vintage Trailer Supply for supplying the tank for this video. And remember, for all your vintage trailer needs, go ahead and run on over to VintageTrailerSupply.com. They've got a lot of really neat stuff there, and there's always somebody there to help you. So, with that, I'm going to say so long. We'll see you next time, and keep on trailering. Remember, folks, I make mistakes so that you don't have to. We'll catch you next time.